Hello everyone, welcome to What You're Smacking. I am one of your hosts this evening, Maxi Bond, your current reigning Miss Sporties 2023.
And my opinion matters because I'm beautiful and you like me. You really like me. Christine Locks.
We are going to be going through and reviewing the promo photos for the divas of season 10 of SmackDown. What season were you on?
That is such a fucking stupid question.
You were last year.
Yeah, I was last year, season 9.
Season 9. I was season 8. Runner up.
8.
8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, eight mama.
Look, I'm Miss Congeniality. I know a lot of... See, no.
Shut the fuck
no.
up. These girls are scared of you already.
No, I don't know why. Okay, see, y'all don't need to be scared of me. I'm very, very nice. I'm very kind. Who you should be scared of is Maxi Bond. First up, we have Skinny Napkin. Oh my god.
What do you like about this?
All right, let me tell you something. First of all, Skinny Napkin is such a great name. I love it.
Same.
Skinny Napkin. Fat boy like Sav.
Beverly Kills posted on Twitter, she goes, Skinny Napkin and Fat Rag.
Skinny Napkin, that's branding with
it
just
is.
Her name. She's white, she's skinny.
And she's as thin as a napkin.
Exactly. I mean, I would call myself brown paper bag. But I didn't.
I just named myself after an ice cream.
Copyright strike.
Copyright.
So, promo photos. Thoughts, okay. Prayers.
I don't love this promo photo because, but the thing is, I think it's intentional. Because we have seen Skinny Napkin perform.
Yeah.
She has performed. She's high energy, looking very gorgeous. And in this photo,
she looks gorgeous.
I thought you weren't living.
No, I am not living for the concept.
Okay, I don't live for the concept, and I don't like the hair.
Hate, hate, hate your hair and makeup today.
Bless the girl, love her, but I'm like, I feel like it could have been better.
Yeah, amazing performer.
Yeah.
Great performer. I really like the makeup. I like the style of the makeup. It's a very woman. I wish conceptually it was more.
I do think I wish there was more of a concept, but at the same time, it's just a photo, and I think she actually did a photo to look intentionally not that great to then wow us at Meet the Queens.
Girl, just imagine if she messages us being like, I thought my mum was great that day.
She's gonna call
us.
I
know exactly what she's gonna do. Meet the Queens.
Name out your fucking mouth!
So up next we have Senora Patricia Ferravella, also known as Senora Patty.
I like the name.
Yeah.
The Senora, it's kind of like, okay, just, you know.
I think that she got ready to do a gig and she took the photo and she said, done! Which is not just her, I think most of the girls have done that. On a positive side, I kind of like the mug. It's really big, it's giving old school, very divine-esque
mug. It is giving very divine.
Very divine. Photoshoot-wise, I think it fell a little flat for me.
Me too.
Like, I get it, it's like Grindr, and you're obviously gonna have a selfie of yours on Grindr.
Mm.
But girl, I've seen the gays, and sometimes they show their entire ass. There was a guy with...
Sometimes the whole body's out.
Sometimes
the whole
dick is out.
Are you homosexual?
So, overall, I just feel like it was lacking a bit of concept.
Yeah.
And I think it could just have been fleshed out a little bit more.
I agree. I love the makeup, but I think it was missing, like, a branding and a concept idea.
Yeah. These girls are gonna go back and watch our photos and be like, why the fuck are these cunts?
Why are these bitches talking? Look how ugly they look.
Ugly. Look how ugly they look.
Okay, so our next girl is Kayla Midia. Christine, what do you think?
First of all, love the name,
Me
Kayla
too.
Midia. Love it. I know she's also friends with Plain Tiffany. And Plain Tiffany is... She is definitely something chaotic.
She was in last season.
So I definitely know that Kayla is also going to be just as chaotic. Mm-hmm. I really like the photo.
Yeah, me too.
The title Cutie Cucumber, she's holding a cucumber, she has a towel on her head, she's in the shop. Mm-hmm. You can think of it about it as like, oh, she's gonna pleasure herself with a cucumber.
Or she know? Just finished douching. I like it as well.
I really like her makeup as well.
Me too. It's not like super dramatic, but it's very glamorous. And I also love the fact that she like has a piece of cucumber with like the shadow reflecting. I don't know if that was intentional, but it's cool.
It is
and
so cool.
Also the cucumber. As you said, it doesn't need to be much, but it's like enough to have a concept.
Yeah. And that's all you need, you know? Just a little concept, just a little bit that goes, oh, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you, when girls study funny, they go like, oh,
quirky!
They
can't roast people being quirky.
No, but like, they go over the top, like, thing, and then eventually you're like, I think this person needs therapy rather than actually.
Did you see a mirror?
Were you silent or were you silenced?
The latter.
Up next, we have Obsidian, or as I like to call her, Obscenity.
You don't have OCD, you have obesity.
What did you think of the promo look?
Okay, I love the name. She always looks gorgeous. My Obsidian's makeup is gorgeous. Her hair is gorgeous.
Yeah.
The earrings are cute.
Gorgeous hair.
But there's no concept.
No concept. Again, this just looks like she got ready for a drag gig, I'm assuming, or just she gone drag for fun. And went out that night.
Took a photo,
called it a day. Promo look, a bit of a letdown.
Yeah, but the name is fun.
The name is fun. Gorgeous wigs, really beautiful makeup, and those really cute earrings. So if I see you, I'm gonna snatch it off you. And probably a wig as well, because you're bald, so you're not pinning it down, so it'll come off easily.
She's fucking, you know what tape is?
Say tape it to a head.
Oh, I don't use it. I have a full like head of hair.
You have a human unit.
Not a soaking clock. So our next drag artist, her name is Lola. She was a showgirl. What do you think?
I love Lola Eclipse so much. She is so fucking stupid. When you spend 4 days on a cruise with that bitch, you are life changed. Do you remember when she did the Maxi?
Have you ever got a fluffy gig? So look, her name was Lola with a purple heart, which I'm assuming is a reference to Donatella Versace with a purple heart.
Donatella Grimoire.
Possibly. It doesn't work if it's just Lola with a purple heart. Maybe she did Lola Eclipse. Purple heart, because Donatella literally says Donatella Versace, purple heart.
Okay.
I didn't live for the promo photo.
Neither.
I
love you, Lola, but I'm sorry.
I did not get it. I don't get the brand. I don't get what Lola is. Lola is this. She's crazy, but she's free.
I am fucking crazy.
Lola's mug has evolved.
It's improved,
but it's, and I'm gonna pluck your tear a little bit, girl. It's going a bit of a Frankie direction, which is a good direction, because Frankie, gorgeous mug.
Gorgeous.
Beautiful makeup. In the promo photo, it feels like you tried to recreate Frankie's mug, but weren't as successful as Frankie. No! It just doesn't turn out well when you try to copy someone else's mug. Take elements of their mug, absolutely.
Don't. But we didn't know if she tried to do that. Look around, everybody on mute.
Girl.
Look around, it's me and my crew. Big energy.
So our next contender is Jacinta Faye.
Jacinta Faye. Look, I think they could have been more done with this. Like, your name's Jacinta Faye. She could have done like
facial,
yes, like facial girl or like facial something, like facial winner or
You know,
instead of faceful win because it's like
I just don't like when like a girl's like,
I'm gonna win.
Yeah, I'm gonna win. Because if you don't, that's a bit more embarrassing, you know? The wet hair, I like it. It's like, I think she's using her actual hair.
I think it's her natural hair. Yeah.
And you know what? Some girls can pull off using their natural hair. Jacinta is one of them.
You can pull off using your natural hair. I'll give you
I
that.
I can.
Her hair looks gorgeous. No.
Stifler. Noah.
Stifler.
Again, concepts are missing of this promo shoot.
Just a little bit.
There was no concept. I think the name could have been a bit more face sexually related or grindery or something, right? I mean, not everything has to be sexual, I guess, but I think it's kind of like,
yeah,
it'll be something more than that.
Absolutely. That being said, Jacinta, just maybe a concept or something, you know, I'm surprised that no one's done like a ball gag in the mouth. Like, again, like, your name is Jacinta Face. Do something with the face.
Shut the fuck up.
I look good, don't I? I look good. Ah! Carter, I look good. I look good.
Ah! And our next performer is Jamai Desplaise. Jamai Desplaise.
Don't touch her Coke Zero. Where the fuck is my Coke Zero?
Jeez.
Did you drink it? Fuck my life. Don't touch my Coke Zero.
She's gonna be one to watch.
She's one to watch. A dancer, a singer,
a performer,
and production value every single time.
Every time she's on the
stage. She brings the house of Machino, they serve.
Machino? Machino. You mean Moscato?
Connor, call the Uber. They are trained dancers, you're a trained wreck, but... Conceptually, I think I get your concept more than Maxi because it's more leatherish. So I feel like you're paying homage to Tom of Finland. Yeah, she had that leather cap, she had the spike things around her neck.
Yeah.
But I just wish that there was a bit more. Because, you know, when I think of Jamai, I think something like so unique that no one's talking about it, you know?
Something like completely out of the blue.
Personally, for me, it felt just a little flat. I still love the makeup. I still love the overall concept, the vibe that you were going for. I like it. I just wish that
it happened. I agree. I think it, like, missed the mark a little bit, but the makeup and everything else was really cool.
Jamai's one of the girls who I would think that she would like tie herself up in ropes completely just for the promo photo.
That's what I, to be honest, that's what I was expecting as well.
Yeah.
I was expecting to see something like super out there.
Hi sisters! Who's next? It's Miss Miss Ivory Tusk.
Miss Ivory.
Ivory Tusk.
Not every name needs to be sexual, you fag.
What is it?
Queen.
I really like the makeup. It's
I think that's the best makeup I've ever looked in that photo.
Yeah, it's really, really beautiful.
Is it an old photo?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Is it an old photo? I really like your makeup. I love the pink fluffy around it. It almost looks like she's being pushed out of a vagina.
Girl, that's a booty hole.
I like it, but again, you are giving pageant when the theme is not calling.
I disagree because it could still be. The thing is, it's not like not calling for pageant, I would say that. But I would say you can still do like that glamorous pageant drag with that element of like grinder, grunge, dirty, sexy type of thing.
No, I kind of agree with you on that. Like, you know what, maybe you have changed my opinion. I love Ivory's photos. I don't know what I said before.
You're gonna lose a hand?
No! This just hit me. Ivory, girl, you are known for having big boobs. You are known for having a breastplate. And even if you want to go the pageanty way, that's what was missing.
Ciao. Anyway, so.
Our next performer is Incubus. Bitch,
This is what I mean.
Incubus, I just want you to let you know that you actually showed the girls how it's done. And I absolutely love everything you've done!
You can back up a little bit.
That is how it's done, and this is what I want to see!
This is what I want to see!
Oh! I loved it! Oh my god!
I agree. Every single bit about it is amazing.
Bitch, you ate that up.
She came as a demonic grinder logo. Like,
that is so good. The nails, the nails.
Yeah, we haven't got
one. The nails, the nails.
But
the,
like, hold on, can I say this again?
Yeah,
let's see. Bitch, and the eyelashes through the face thing, like, Incubus's drag is very, like, very fucking, like, you don't know what you're gonna get.
The black backdrop,
yeah,
and she's wearing a black bodysuit. I'm
like,
assuming
that's full coverage.
But
like,
the thing is that she accentuated it with the gray strokes on the bodysuit. Girls, you ate that, and this is what we wanted. That little cunty little removal of the mask, girl.
Yeah, 100%.
It's not sexy.
No.
It's not pretty.
No.
But it is.
It's not
cunt.
How could you not say cunt? Like,
so
that's cunt. Like,
I know people will be there, oh, but I can't see her face. I don't give a fuck. I really don't give a fuck. This is so good. Mm. You can't see her face. Okay, but it's gonna be on her profile. And you'll know it's Incubus.
It's
that
amazing.
Is so well done. Incubus, props to you. The best look.
Yeah.
The best
I
look.
I think it's one of the best promo photos ever in SmackDown history.
Wow. That was so powerful.
And the next drag competitor, one of my closest friends, Miss Helen Wills.
Helen Wills, vroom vroom, motherfucker.
Beep beep, y'all better move out of the way.
I love the name, but I wish there was a bit more of a concept in this.
Absolutely. I really wish there was a little bit more of a concept, because Helen is known for pulling out a concept. She always pulls out a concept. Meals on Wheels, the party bus, Abby Lee Miller. Oh my god!
You preach theater etiquette, put it away.
I don't know, I think I'm gonna go to Baskin Robbins.
And that's the thing, I love it. It's a really pretty photo. Mm-hmm. It's gorgeous, she looks beautiful. Just a concept, but have a nice Hot Wheels.
Love it.
Fucking fun.
Phenomenal name.
Or maybe if she said, like, what else? Car Fun.
Oh, Car Fun.
Because she does, like, Helen Party
Bus.
What
is it? What is it? Bad Taxi.
Bad Taxi. Oh my god. Helen could have pulled up, Helen, you could have pulled up the Helen Taxi. And then put like, what's it called? Bait Bus or whatever.
Bait Bus. Oh, that's funny.
That would have been funny. But
Hot Wheels is so cool.
Hot Wheels is camp. Love it. I am so excited to see what Helen brings this year.
Me too, because she did so well last year already.
So well.
So she's just going to keep going up. The next performer is Dilemma.
I'm sorry, Dilemma. I actually really, really hated your promo look. I'm just kidding. No, I actually liked it.
I love it.
It is so smart. You went as a sexy nun, and this is what I mean. She showed her entire outfit, because you can see the mirror. It's really nice, it's really well thought out.
I agree, because it's like, literally, as you said, you've got to take a photo. Yes, we understand you've got to take a photo, but there's ways to show the whole outfit.
Yes.
There's also ways to make it sexy in camp.
Yes.
And
holy from the front, party in the back, you know? Holy at the back.
Wait,
as well.
No, it's holy. Holy at the front, holy in the face.
And you're ashy in the face. And broken in the legs.
Broken in the feet.
And wide in the hips.
What?
Why? And crinkled in the legs.
Wide in the face.
Wide?
Wide
face?
Just in the I hate us.
I know. So our next drag performer is Charity.
Give it up for Miss Minge. Work.
Her name on
is
Mo Lady.
Mo Lady.
Mo, Mo Lady.
Please give it up for Mo Lady.
Now that we've collected ourselves for the second time, let's talk about
okay.
Stop it!
Charity. Also known as Mole.
Charity. Which is where Christine gets her drag.
Please.
Which is what she was asking for when she was on her scooter.
Spin change, sir.
Wait, weren't you the pigeon lady from Home Alone? Now that we've collected ourselves for the nth number of times, let's finally talk about Charity. What did you think about her look?
It was like,
I don't know. Sorry, Charity. I'm sure you're lovely. I didn't live. I love the name Mo Lady. I think that's fucking funny. Obviously, because she has a moustache.
Yeah.
But the outfit, the makeup was fine, but it was just, again, it was just a selfie.
Sorry, Maxie's been such a cunt and so rude and disrespectful, and that's so mean to say! But no, I don't like it either. So. The hair was cute, the pigtails.
The pigtails were cute.
Yeah.
I like the pigtails.
Yeah, no. I just, like, the thing is that after watching Incubuses and Dilemmas...
Yeah, I agree. Like, all to yeah. Shade, it just wasn't, there's nothing really special about it.
Props to you for the name Mole Lady, very funny name.
Just you might just need to fight Miss Minj for some branding. And the final performer is Bella Belle.
This one.
What do you think of the look?
I like it. I like the lashes. I love the makeup. What do you think about the wig?
I don't like the hair. I'm sorry. That hair.
Okay.
She's just like, she's there in a fucking dolly. Okay. Just like, I'm sorry. That
is a show for talented people. Not people that know how to buy
shoes. She's there in a fucking dolly.
You should not be here.
The same one that Skinny Duncan was wearing.
Exactly.
It is! Okay, but this is the thing. It looks better on Bella than it did on Skinny. And I have nothing against Skinny because I'm fatty. But like, I... Anyway, back to Bella. I like the wig. Okay, there was nothing groundbreaking about the photo. Sorry, Bella. Love you. But the lashes were really cool.
The lashes
were really cool.
This is the gag though. Bella has Skinny Napkin's wig on. Talking. And Incubus' lashes.
Yeah.
Incubus had those lashes.
Yeah. The lashes were cool. The wig looked better on Bella than it did on Skinny. I'm sorry, I don't hate Skinny Napkin.
Drag
her. I do not have
Slay her. Read her. Sipping on that treaty, hunty. I live. This is giving me life, hunty. Yes, mama. Yes.
So, Miss Bourne, now that we've gone through all the girls, who are your top three? Just from the promo looks.
Just from the promo looks alone, I'm gonna say Incubus, Dilemma, and Kayla Media.
And who are your bottom three?
Are we doing no?
I'll say it.
Okay, you're gonna do the bottom three. Who are your bottom three?
So my bottom three are...
here we go.
So personally, that was my bottom three because I just did not like it at all. Was that too harsh? So that was our little review on the promo looks.
That was our little review.
So you said it like...
Okay, Miss Helga from Oblongs. We'll see you in the coming weeks where we review the Meet the Queens. And trust and believe there are a few twists and shenanigans, aren't there?
Well, I've been Maxie Bond.
And I'm the gorgeous diva, Christine Locke, something that she can never be. And we will see you soon.
Mo Lady! Mo Lady! Mo... Mo Lady! Mo Lady! Okay, I'm gonna cut.